that metal interview.
Brutal death metal fanatics, you are in for a treat on this episode of That Metal Interview, as we have as our guest, straight from Belgium, one of the greatest death metal bands to grace the planet for sure, man. A band by the name of ABORTED. We have the lead vocalist, Sven De Caluwe, if I am pronouncing that last name correctly. Sven spends time with us and talks to us about his side projects and ABORTED's brand new album. It just came out, you know. It's just a badass album with Century Media. And you guys have to check it out, man. Century Media Records. You guys can find it on your favorite streaming service. An album by the name of ManiaCult. ManiaCult. ABORTED, man. You guys want to hear some crazy, crazy death metal. Death metal. And Century Media Records presents ABORTED, man. So before we continue, as you guys know, I usually play and spin a song from the band. So let's hear Drag Me to Hell. ABORTED. Be right back. Drag Me to Hell Indeed, a great composition, a crazy composition by the death metal band from Belgium. There you go. That was the visualizer video. For those of you checking out our YouTube version of this interview, ABORTED, Sven, lead vocalist, or death metal vocalist, shall we say. And anyways, let's check it out, man. Sven is going to spend time with us and talks to us about his side projects and other projects that he is exclusively telling us about. Some new stuff that he is presenting to us. So here it is. Let's check out the interview with ABORTED, man. Sven, here it is. How's everything in your part of the country with the COVID and all that?
It's okay, you know. We're surviving. things are okay now. I think about 80% of the population is vaccinated or more, so it's slowly getting back to normal. We had a festival here this weekend which had 75,000 people, no masks, no nothing. You could get in if you were tested or vaccinated, so that worked out, I guess.
Awesome. That's good news for us metalheads, huh? Awesome. So, ManiaCult via Century Media, talk to us about this album. Did you guys aim for a sound like the last album, Terrorvision, or did you guys take a different approach, you know?
Well, it's kind of different because I think we wanted to create, you know, we wanted to start off where Terrorvision left, but we wanted to create a much more dynamic record. So there's a lot of things we haven't done in a while that came back. There's some stuff that really, you know, goes back to, let's say, even Engineering the Dead, Gormageddon, or Archaic Abattoir. There's some stuff that's absolutely new. So there's a lot of different stuff happening in the record, I think. And, that's pretty much the direction we wanted to go into.
Man, this is some crazy, crazy awesome metal. You know, as a fan, you know, you guys are putting out some badass stuff. You know, this is great for us fans, you know. Who wrote the material, the riffs, you know, the lyrics? Is it you and Ken, or who does all the work?
Yeah, basically. Ken wrote about 90% of the record musically. Of course, we're all involved and we're helping structures and ideas and shit, but basically Ken wrote the majority of it. And then their lyrics are my department, of course.
Awesome, man. Man, I have to say this, man. You have either the best or one of the best drummers ever, man. Crazy, man, just crazy. how did you find this guy?
Yeah, a little bastard is good.
Way better than good.
Well, it's funny enough, when we, the funny thing is that he's just as good on guitar as he's on drums, so wow. It's an added bonus.
Oh, wow.
But yeah, how do we find him? He used to be in a band called Abigail Williams, and he joined the band back in 2010,
yeah.
I want to say.
Uh-huh.
And he joined us, and then he quit Abigail Williams and hasn't looked back, and he's been here ever since, and we couldn't be more happy. The guy is kind of like my little brother. We've been through a lot together with the band, and couldn't do it without him.
So take us back to the beginning. At what point did you know you had a death metal voice, you know? At what point did you say, you know what, I discovered that I can sing like this, let me try and make a band? Or and what year was this? Or
that's a long time ago. That was back in 95, I think. I was doing, I grew up in a small town here that had a pretty active metal scene. There's a lot of local bands here, and that's kind of how I rolled in it. One of the local bands, their singer back in the day, was terrible at writing lyrics, so they asked me if I could help him out, and I did. I helped him with vocal placements and everything, and it sort of started from there, where I just was like, you know what, why the fuck am I helping someone else when I could be doing, you know, my own band?
Yeah,
so
yeah, yep.
It started that way, you know. Yeah.
Cool story there. So I saw the video. I saw the video visualizer for Drag Me to Hell. Awesome, man. Who comes up with these ideas? The characters, the graphics. That's some badass stuff, man.
Yeah, so I mean, for this record, we kind of work backwards. Usually, we come up with a concept, have some artwork made, and then, you know, build the entire universe around it, the merch, the pre-orders, the videos, all that stuff. This time, we sort of went backwards, and we were like, all right, what kind of retarded stuff do we want to do with this record? What kind of silly, stupid, nerdy thing can we do?
Yeah.
To build something around, actually, and a friend of mine makes custom He-Man figures. And he's like, why don't we have an aborted figure? And so it kind of went from that. We decided to do an aborted figure. We came up with this new mascot for the band called Waylon Thurston, who's like an 80s type of slasher.
Okay.
And we made a whole story around it, that he's this deranged maniac that wants to enslave and destroy mankind by summoning demons and opening portals to other dimensions and shit. I gave the brief to Par Olofsson that did the artwork. But everything had to be a metaphor to kind of like the crazy stuff that's been happening the last couple of years.
Yeah.
And, you know, a metaphor to mental health issues and stuff like that. So that's kind of portrayed in the artwork with all the, you know, the demons that are around this dude's head are voices. It's actually crazy, so that's basically what it's about. And the guy just made it work, and then, you know, we did the visualizer, so starting off of that.
Very cool, man. How about Impetus Odie? Is that the correct pronunciation? Awesome song, of course. Video, badass.
I mean, it's Latin,
right? Yeah.
Thank you.
Where did you shoot that?
It's Latin, so you're I was gonna say your guess is as good as mine is how it's pronounced.
Right. But it's a cool title. Where did you shoot that? And who came up with the ideas
Thank
for the
you.
Video?
So basically, we sent the lyrics to the production company G13. They're in Poland, and they came up with this whole elaborate plot that you see in the video. So it's all their idea. I told them, you know, what the song was about, gave them the lyrics. They sent, you know, the two different drafts to choose from. We picked the one that it ultimately became. And I asked them to elaborate a little bit more on it, because it was like, the brief was pretty funny, because I'll never forget. I wrote a line, I read a line where it said, and then the midget Pope enters, and I was like, what? What the hell does that have to do with the song? So it was, you know, they're like, just trust us, it's gonna be cool, and it turned out cool. And it was shot in Poland. They did all the work in one day with all the actors. Crazy experience due to, you know, COVID. I was the only one able to travel there and actually do the video. But, you know, hopefully in the future we can do some more videos when things are
very cool. I saw that. So give us an update on Bent C.
Yeah, Bent C has a lot coming up. Dirk wrote 2.5 albums now, and I'm finishing the recordings to one of the albums this or next week, and then it'll get mixed by Daniel Bergstrand, and I guess it's gonna be released. Yeah, it's again a step up from the last material. It's still Shane Embry on bass, Dirk on drums and guitars, and then I'm doing vocals.
Awesome. Can't wait to hear that. So I heard in another interview of yours, I heard of a new band you're formed, Fetal Blood Eagle. For people that don't know what that is, can you give us an update on that?
Yes, sir. Yeah, so friends of mine from New England started a new band called Fetal Blood Eagle. And they recorded their first album and didn't have a singer at the time. And they asked me, you know, their guitarist Jim is a good friend of mine. And he sold merch for Cryptopsy on the tour we did together.
Yeah.
Before COVID, and he asked me if I'd be down to do vocals for it, and I heard the material, I really liked it, so knocked out the record, and it's coming out early next year on Listenable Records. It's musically something between I'd say Cannibal Corpse, Hate Eternal kind of stuff, but with, you know, with its own merit. It's death metal, it's extreme, and it's based on hooks.
Awesome.
It's a very cool record. Christian Donaldson, Cryptopsy, mixed it, and I'm looking forward to have people check it out soon.
I can't wait for that either. Very cool. So, how about Coffin Theater? What's going on there?
Well, as well as I'm finishing recording Ben C, I'm finishing recording EP for Coffin Theater called Stereo Homicide. We're finishing up this week. Christian Donaldson's going to mix it as well. And that should be out somewhere October, November this year. It's going to have five tracks of sort of mixture of grindcore with some hardcore elements. And everything is kind of tied in together with a lot of, I don't want to say orchestrations, but like, it sounds like a grindcore metal hardcore band playing a horror movie, something like that. And there's a lot of horror movie sonorities going on in there. It's a pretty interesting mix. It's something you haven't heard before, that's for sure.
Awesome. Very cool. So, what's your favorite ABORTED song to play live?
Oof.
they're all badass, of course. They're all good.
That's tough. I'd say can I pick two?
Sure.
That's easier.
Yeah.
I'd say Cadaver's Banquet is definitely one of them. And Sanguine Versus from Gormageddon. Got the big ball of death moment where people are punching the crap out of each other, and it's just cool to see.
Very cool. Good choices. They're all badass to me. I would be having a hard time choosing a song. So, who are your influences?
Yeah, for all 11 now.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Go ahead.
Yes, who are your influences? Who are your heroes?
I think now we're just doing our own thing, but when we started, for sure, for me personally, back in the day, it was Bo Summers from Illdisposed, Frank Mullen from Suffocation, and Jeff Walker from Carcass. Those are the guys that, you know, I really looked up to as a vocalist back in the day, and kind of made me want to do this stuff. Now there's all these crazy-ass kids out there now, like Ben Doer, that Alex the Terrible dude, the guy from Lorna Shore, fucking the Goblin King, what's his face? Dickie Allen, all those guys are absolutely crazy. There's a lot of sick singers out there. Musically, for sure, for us, back in the day, it was Suffocation, Entombed, Slayer, Hatebreed, Dying Fetus, Carcass, you know, stuff like that.
Nice, wow. All good names, all badass bands, for sure. What kind of music do you listen to when you're not writing or when you're not doing one of your projects? What's on your playlist? Do you just strictly listen to metal, or do you have other likes, you know?
I listen to metal mainly, but I listen to a lot of other stuff. Like, I like to listen to a lot of the 80s, like synthwave kind of stuff is really fun.
Yeah.
And a lot of stuff that I've started collecting on vinyl are original soundtracks of horror movies. For some reason, it really relaxes me when I'm working, so I'm listening to a lot of John Carpenter and stuff like that.
Oh, wow. Wow. That's very cool. Wow. So when are you guys hitting the road? When are you guys starting the tour? What can fans expect next from you?
Well, next year, for sure. This year, we're still fucked with the whole COVID situation, unfortunately. But next year, we should be heading for Europe on the Hell Over Europe tour with our good friends in Benighted, the Acacia Strain, and Flood of Valkyrie. I think for the summer, we're aiming to go back to the States. And if everything goes well, I think we'll be doing Latin America as well next year. But, you know, it's all depending on how the situation goes and what actually gets booked, you know.
Very cool. Can't wait to see you guys in the States, here in Texas. I've never seen you guys live, so looking forward to that.
Yeah, for sure.
Would you like to send a message to your fans listening to this podcast?
Yeah, for sure, man. I hope everybody's doing safe out there, and we all miss shows as much as you guys, so hopefully, you know, check out ManiaCult if you dig it. It comes out September 10th, and hopefully we can see you when we're on tour next summer in the U.S.
Thank you. Thank you, Sven. Thank you for making time, and can't wait to hear the rest of the album. ManiaCult, September 10th.
Thank you, man.
Yeah, we hope to see you guys on the road soon, man.
Right on.
Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell for notifications. That way you won't miss anything or any of our new uploads to your ears and to your streaming services. For those of you fanatics of That Metal Interview podcast, thank you guys and girls for your support. 1 million times for sure, man. Thank you guys. On behalf of myself, your friend and host, James. And we welcome the new guys, new people checking out our podcast, man. Awesome. So, a new guest every episode. Well, sometimes we repeat guests as they will return to present their latest effort and release, right? So, we've had a couple of repeat offenders, shall we say. But anyways, thank you guys one more time. Thank you for liking us on Facebook. Check out our radio station, jrocksmetalzone.com. 24/7 rock metal, man. So anyways, check out ABORTED's greatest badass album, brand new stuff that just came out, ManiaCult, ABORTED. And we thank Sven, the great death metal vocalist for ABORTED, for spending time with us. And thank you to Century Media Records for providing such badass music and artists to us, headbangers and thrashers and whatever you want to call yourselves, just the way I am. So thank you guys, and don't forget to keep it metal.
Metal Interview.